Hello everyone, this is Haley back with another Dragon Prince video. I am so excited to get to talk about the Dragon Prince again, but this time we now have a confirmed release date for Season 4 of the show. And for those of you who might not heard yet, Season 4 is officially coming out on November 3rd. You heard that right, it's less than a month away. I'm going to be breaking down everything we got at the New York Comic Con panel, where we got a release date, a trailer, some new character art, and a few other tidbits. The audience also got to see Episode 1 of Season 4, much like I did at San Diego Comic Con. So, there will be Episode 1 spoilers in this video. Stay tuned until the end where I reveal something very special that'll be a big part of any future Dragon Prince videos. Now, let's get started with the trailer. We start with a repeat of what we learned in the Resurrection clip. Claudia has managed to bring her father Viren back to life after 2 years of being dead, but she's only able to keep him alive for 30 days unless they find and free Aaravos. The first new shot we see is of Zubea flying across the sky and heading towards a mountain. The mountain could definitely be Umber Tor, which might be the lair of Rex Igneous. Ezrin then announces that Zubea and Zim are coming to Catalyst, which we learn from episode 1 of the new season. We see a shot of Ibis and Zim, and it's honestly so crazy to see how much Zim has grown. The next shot has Callum being surprised for his birthday party. He's about to cast a spell and quickly has to shoot it away from the crowd. Ezrin later approaches Callum, who's run away from his own party since it's the 2-year anniversary of when Rayla left to go find Viren, which happened to be on Callum's 15th birthday. As we saw in the teaser trailer, Callum somehow has one of Rayla's swords. It is unclear if he has had them since she left, or if he finds it later in the season. It is then finally revealed what was in the chrysalis this whole time. It definitely isn't Aaravos, as we later see is still in the mirror, but is instead a smaller creature that has butterfly wings and creepily long fingers. It does have many similarities to Aaravos, with its overall design and star primal symbol on its chest. Viren is kneeling down in front of it, and it would make sense that this creature could help lead him to where he needs to go. We get a shot that mirrors what we saw in the first teaser, which is going to be the opening for the new season. But instead of Aaravos holding a tiny statue of Viren, it is of Callum holding the key of Aaravos. From what I can recall, this is the first time we have seen Aaravos acknowledge Callum, so this is very exciting. A shot of Callum in his study is then shown, which will be the first of many. The star primal starts to glow. I do think it's important to note that Bait is the color red here, which means he is angry. I will circle back to this later. Aaravos blows the mirror a kiss, which causes it to shatter. I definitely want to know if he was just speaking to Callum and was saying his goodbyes. This shot is most likely what inspired the poster for the season. While this is happening, Callum says, "In darkness, gaze upon a fallen star." I think this clue is what leads him to Aaravos for the first time. It is, after all, the way that Viren was first able to meet Aaravos by extinguishing all the light in the room. The next shot is of Zubea and Pyrrha flying together to join humans at an event. We get our first shot of Soren in the trailer, and he is next to Corvus. This then jumps to another shot with the same characters, but at a different location. This is where King Harald's funeral was held. Behind Ezrin is a painting that was actually given out at a convention a few years ago. It features young Ezrin and Zim looking up at Zubea. Looks like this is canon now, which is kind of funny. But here it seems like someone is sending a message to Zubea, as her head is cut out of the painting. I know not everything will be all peaceful between humans and Zadia now, so maybe the center is presenting themselves. From episode 1 of the season, we get to see Junai propose to Amaya, though things do not go as planned. The scenes of them in the forest are definitely from that episode. Then we see our first of many shots in the trailer that take place at the Storm Spire. It appears that Claudia and Terry are up on the bridge there, and we get to see them sitting next to each other. Claudia still has the corrupted sun staff that came from the High Priests of the Sunfire Elves. We did see Claudia with a braid in the poster where Aaravos is puppeteering a few characters, so it is nice to finally see her with it in the show. It looks like Terry is the one who braided her hair, which makes so much sense. In a way, it shows that she is intertwined with both light and dark. It reminds me of Soren's original outfit, which always felt to me so evenly divided between black and white, showing that he would have to one day choose between the two. The symbolism with Claudia could be similar, but perhaps she can embrace both in some way, and Terry is the one who helps her get there. From the following scene where Claudia is inside the spire, it seems like they were deciding what to do to give Viren's staff back. It appears she almost grabs it without incident, but at the last moment Ibis shows up to stop her. They seem to have a big fight, and at one point it seems like Ibis has the upper hand and is ready to deal the final blow, but it seems like he pays the ultimate price. The shot we get of a large blanket could definitely be covering Ibis, who likely did not make it out of that battle alive. If he is really dead, I'm kind of upset they showed this in the trailer, since it is directly pointing us to think he was defeated. The next shot we get is our first look of Rayla, but I will save talking about her for later. Birds may have been let out to signify the passing of Ibis, which was fitting since he was a Skywing elf. These birds do happen to have the same markings as Ibis, so maybe there is some hope that he's not completely gone. Callum now has Ibis's staff, as we see it in other shots in the trailer. We get a quick shot of Zubea opening the gates of wherever she is at, right after we see these golem-like creatures that likely guard the lairs of Rex Igneous. These could definitely be the guardians of the Great Gates, which we know about because of the index card shown to us as out-of-context spoilers from Comic-Con a year ago. Perhaps Hubeya opens the lair by herself first, and then lets Callum and Ezra return there later. Things are now getting super interesting, and we get our first look at Kareem, who is the younger brother of Janai, the now queen of the Sunfire Elves. He is sitting next to Amaya and Gren, and they might be watching a trial of some sort. Now that Lux Aria, the capital city, was destroyed, it's possible they have to move all events elsewhere. And this new place is, well, old. But what makes this interesting is that this event is being spectated by a bunch of elves, as well as humans. They're watching what seems to be a prisoner who has burns on her hands. Behind the prisoner and Janai seem to be the Six Horns, who are elite Sunfire Elf generals. This is another thing we saw from one of the index cards revealed a while ago. Perhaps she's being punished for grabbing something meant to only be touched by Sunfire Elves. A Sunforged blade is drawn, and Amaya seems very shocked about this. I imagine the scene will entail Janai cutting the handcuffs off the human instead of cutting off her hands. This may have caused a disagreement between Kareem and Janai, as they have different ideas about what they should have done to the human. We do later see a shot of Kareem attacking someone. In this shot to the very left, it seems we may be getting our first look at Miana, who was revealed last year at New York Comic Con. We don't know too much about her besides that she is the most important of the Six Horns. There's also a quick shot of Viren falling off the storm spire. Perhaps he is out of breath, or the consequences of being alive for so long is starting to affect him. Then we get the first of many sequences inside a cave, which could be where Rex Igneous resides. There's an anglerfish kind of creature that goes after bait. It makes perfect sense considering his name. These creatures may actually be related to the Underglow Dragon, which was introduced to us in the Tales of Zadia. We get a shot of Soren, which we have already seen before, but I'm obligated to mention it again, because it's Soren. Interestingly, we get a shot of Callum with completely black eyes. Callum, what are you doing messing around with dark magic again? Didn't you learn your lesson last time? Hopefully, this is a fake out of some sort. Back in the cave, we see a shot of Zim, Ezrin, Callum, and Rayla. But there's also one other elf there, and it seems to be some sort of Earthblood elf, as they look a lot like Terry. Maybe there's some relation between the two of them, and with this elf, they were able to enter Rex Igneous's lair. One of the final shots I want to mention is definitely one of the most important. Rayla returns! Or at least, so it seems. She's in her Moonshadow form before revealing herself. She has a totally new look, but also a new friend with her. From the panel, we learn that this is a cuddle monkey named Stella. If you look closely, you'll see she has six limbs, which is very unique. And another unique thing about her is that she activates the Star Primal on the Key of Aaravos. This is the first time we have seen any creature do this, so if Rayla suddenly returned and brought with her a companion that can use the Star Primal, there are so many cool possibilities. What sort of amazing abilities could this cute creature have? Cuddle monkeys were actually first revealed in Tales of Zadia, where they are mentioned as one of the creatures that had the Star Arcanum. However, they are extremely unique because we also learned at the panel that they are born without being tied to a specific Arcanum. But as they grow, they discover which Primal they are connected to and get different abilities based off of that. Stella was lucky enough to understand the Star Primal. However, many fans are very suspicious of this new creature. They wonder, how come only the Star Primal glows when it is also new Rayla, who knows the Moon Arcanum? And why would they make Stella tied to the Star Arcanum when the only other Star Arcanum being we know is Aaravos, who is a big bad of the series? And most notably, why would Rayla return back to Callum and the others when she clearly has not completed her mission of finding Viren as we learned in the graphic novel Through the Moon? Well, assuming she never did find Viren's corpse when Claudia was trying to resurrect it. I see it as a definite possibility that the Rayla that goes to Callum is a fake. Somehow, Aaravos has managed to make a decoy of Rayla and is able to give it commands via Stella. In Hearts of Cinder from Season 3, Aaravos was able to possess the body of the Sunfire High Priest by way of the caterpillar. Perhaps Stella fills a similar role, where she is the one who must be connected to this decoy at all times, or it ceases to exist and its true form will be revealed. That is how this could be a proper decoy, instead of an illusion that a Moonshadow Elf would make. Maybe there is a human Stella was able to bite, and it turned into an unwilling host. Of course, what Aaravos did in Hearts of Cinder showed him in his ghostly form. Being able to show an illusion of someone that is not himself is not something that we have seen him do yet. But this theory brings up the question of how Aaravos would be able to be in contact with Stella while he has been in prison for a very long time. Well, I have a few ideas. As a creature of the Star Arcanum, perhaps Stella is very long-lived. She could be thousands of years old, just like Aaravos, and he trained her since she was really young and was what influenced her to connect to the Star Primal. One really neat thing is that we technically have seen a cuddle monkey for a while now. They're on the constellation map. For some reason, it is playing the cello, but I hope we get to see Stella play one now. But this makes sense why it is there, since they can connect to the Star Arcanum. And something potentially interesting I noticed is that it is really close to the drawing of young Aaravos. This convinces me even more that they have both known each other for a really long time. For another theory, maybe when Stella tapped into the Star Arcanum, she gained a direct connection to Aaravos, who is the only Star Touch elf nearby. Aaravos is very convincing, as we know, so perhaps he was the friend she needed. Whoever the case may be, it was clear from earlier that Bait was not happy with Stella being there. But I'm not totally sure I want this theory to happen. I would love to have Rayla return to Callum and for them to have a new friend who is connected to the Star Arcanum. This is something extremely rare and could help him out in so many different ways. As a nice touch, we see that Callum moved the painting of the girl and the sheep to his study. In front of the painting was where he first met Rayla, so it is perfect that they meet again right next to it. In the next shot, we get to see Rayla being chased by an Earthblood elf, who is flying a dragon. Well, a drake to be specific, because it has two legs and wings for arms. This is likely taking place in the Drakewood, which we have learned from Tales of Zadia is an area west of Umber Tor that is filled with hostile, territorial Earthblood elves who are called Drake Riders. As you might guess, these elves ride on the backs of drakes, and this scene fits that description to a T. We do not see Stella in these shots with Rayla, interestingly enough. Perhaps this is the real Rayla and she never left Zadia? Our final shot in the trailer is of Rex Igneous, who seems to be laughing at the guest to his lair. In an earlier shot, we see that the gang likely woke him up from a long slumber. And that about wraps it up for my analysis of the trailer. Not too bad for something that was less than 2 minutes long. Now to very briefly go over what we saw at New York Comic Con besides the trailer, we got some new key art of the characters. This includes Claudia, Soren, Amaya, Janai, Ezrin, Zim and Bait, Callum, Viren, and finally, Rayla. The most notable part of the Q&A section was what I mentioned before with the new info about Stella. And from what I can tell, since I was sadly not there, that was most of what we learned. If there was anything you think I missed, let me know in the comments section down below. Now, time to reveal my surprise. And that is, I've been made into an elf. My friend and talented artist Snowflake Owl drew this for me, and eventually it'll be my new mini Haley. I even have some really exciting plans for this elf in the future, so make sure to subscribe to get notified of any future schemes I get into with this elf-sona. I hope you love her as much as I do. A huge shout out to my friends who helped contribute to this video. Oh, and for Haro for doing the editing. If you want to chat with them, join the Cartoon Viewers Discord server. Thank you for watching, and have an animated day!